Marvin. One day, at the amusement park, Marvin was testing the new roller coaster, the Zombie Cave. It was midnight, all the people had left the park, and it was now time for Marvin to work his second job as a ride tester for the park. Marvin had to take this extra job because his regular job didn't pay very well. You see, Marvin was not very good at being a clown. No, he wasn't very funny at all. Although his face had a big painted smile, inside he was not happy, and people could tell. He was recently divorced. His wife left him for the owner of the amusement park, Chester, the super rich guy that had all the power. And because Marvin was sad, nobody laughed at his jokes. Because let's face it, when you're sad, you're just not that funny. Marvin used to be funny, but he was not a rich man. His clothes were tattered, which is why he liked wearing the clown outfit. At least it was new. Tonight, as he was riding the new zombie coaster, Marvin had in his hands a cold hot dog he bought earlier that day. Now was a great time to eat it. The long hill upwards gave him plenty of time to wolf down the hot dog, complete with ketchup and mustard and anchovies. And as they reached the top, Marvin swallowed the last bite. He was ready, or was he? As the new coaster raced downward, Marvin began to choke. This was really bad, because he was all alone. To dislodge the piece, Marvin pulled back on the safety bar as hard as he could. To his relief, the hot dog flew out of his mouth and fell to the ground, hitting a poodle on the head. But the force of the bar threw Marvin's head forward, and he banged his head on the front of the car, on the cold steel. It really hurt. It knocked him out. The coaster kept going, and Marvin's lifeless body flailed from side to side. And then the coaster went into the zombie cave. When Marvin woke up, he saw all of the zombies painted on the walls, and the wax sculptures, even the new 3D high-tech video screens. Everything looked pretty cool, he thought. Kids will love it. And then, dun dun dun, he saw his ex-wife with Chester, and they were smooching. This was too much for Marvin. He got out of the car and approached Chester. "Hey, get off my woman," he screamed. And then Marvin's blood curled inside of him. The hair on the back of his neck stood straight up as Chester turned to face him. Marvin noticed something was very wrong. Chester had no eyeballs. And then his ex-wife turned toward him too, and to his horror, she had no face. Marvin screamed like a little girl and tried to run, but he slipped in some rotten cotton candy on the floor and fell. You tried to say rotten cotton candy, I know. Chester, with no eyes, and his ex-wife, with no face, were getting closer and closer, whispering, "Brains." Marvin knew that his fate was sealed. When, just then, the wax zombies began to move, and the zombies on the wall began to crawl out of their paint, and the video screens started oozing with zombie goo. Marvin thought this was surely the end when the zombies walked right past him and attacked Chester and his ex-wife. The next morning, the birds were singing, the bees were buzzing, and the laughter of children could be heard throughout the park. The zombie cave ride was the most popular of all, and for some reason, nobody could find Chester. As for Marvin, children were flocking to him because he was now the funniest, happiest clown in the world. Why? Well, a clown never tells. Dun, dun, dun. Yeah! Well, Simon, what did you think of our clown story?
I liked your clown story.
Simon can't make up his mind.
First one to go, I should have been number three.
19, yay! Paula, always a tender heart. What'd you think of the creepy story?
Well, I have to say, I like roller coasters, and I really like hot dogs, so...
18, yeah! Randy.
Well, I have to agree with Paula that hot dogs are really awesome, but with anchovies though, not quite sure about the anchovies on the hot dog. And clowns, they scare me a little bit. So I'm gonna have to go with a 16.
16. You know? You never know, children. You never know who's gonna read your story, what parts of it they're gonna like or what they're not gonna like. Some people don't like clowns. I don't know who drew that picture, but that is a great, great clown picture.